Today, the Karnataka High Court heard a petition seeking to nullify the election of state's Chief Minister Siddaramaiah from the Varuna constituency. The petitioner K.M. Shankar alleged electoral malpractice in the 2023 Assembly elections, including promises of free benefits. Senior advocate Pramila Nesargi, representing the petitioner, argued that the consolidated fund cannot be used to offer free benefits, and implementing such schemes without passing a financial bill is a misuse of taxpayers' money. She stated that Siddaramaiah solicited votes based on guarantees and campaigned as a candidate, raising questions about the electoral process. Nesargi further argued that Siddaramaiah personally promised freebies under the guarantee scheme across the state, which is a serious violation and grounds for his election to be annulled. During the hearing, the High Court inquired when the Congress manifesto was published. Nesargi replied that it was released after the nomination process, which she claimed was a violation of the law. The petitioner also argued that giving 2,000 rupees to women has made them lazy, pointing out that while providing financial aid to those unable to work due to age or disability is different, giving free money to healthy individuals is wrong. Delhi's Rao's Avenue Court has postponed the hearing in the case against former Delhi Commission for Women chairperson and AAP MP Swati Malwal concerning irregularities in appointments within the commission. The court has scheduled the next hearing for October 1st. On Saturday, the court directed that the Delhi High Court's order be submitted in the case. In December 2022, the Rao's Avenue Court had ordered charges to be framed against Swati Malwal and four other accused. This decision was challenged in Delhi High Court, which on September 20th rejected Malwal's petition, refusing to interfere within the trial court's ruling. Apart from Malwal, charges were framed against DCW members Pramila Gupta, Sarika Chaudhary and Farheen Malik under Section 120B of the Indian Penal Code and Sections 13(2) and 13(1D of the Prevention of Corruption Act. The case will now continue on October 1st. Rao's Avenue Court has postponed the hearing on the sentencing of AAP MLA from Deoli, Prakash Jadwal, who was convicted in Dr. Rajendra Singh's suicide case. Special Judge Kaveri Baveja has scheduled the next hearing for September 30. On Saturday, MLA Prakash Jadwal sought permission to present new evidence in court. Another accused in the case, Harish Jadwal, has challenged the trial court's conviction order in the High Court. Apart from Prakash Jadwal, Kapil Nagar and Harish Kumar Jadwal were also accused in the case. On February 28, the court convicted Prakash Jadwal and Kapil Nagar under various sections of the IPC, while Harish Jadwal was acquitted of some charges. Dr. Rajendra Singh had died by suicide on April 18, 2020, holding Jadwal and Nagar responsible. The Allahabad High Court has refused to grant relief to the accused involved in preparing a fake death certificate for Pakistani national Jafri Begum to register her property under their names in revenue records. The bench of Justices V.K. Birla and A.K. Singh Deshwal rejected the petition filed by Farhana and Sadrul Islam, considering the FIR to be cognizable. Additionally, the court dismissed another petition filed by Mohit Sachan, stating that he was not named in the FIR. Jafri Begum had moved to Pakistan during the partition of India. In 2008, she spent a few days in India before returning to Karachi, where she passed away on January 28, 2011. The allegation is that Ajaz Ahmed registered Jafri Begum's property under his name using fake death certificate. The accused claimed they purchased the property legally, but the court rejected their argument, noting that Jafri Begum's property was categorized as enemy property and that this illegal transaction is a serious offense. The Supreme Court has taken suo motu cognizance of Karnataka High Court Justice V. Srishanand's controversial remark referring to a part of Bangalore as Pakistan. The remark, which went viral on social media, was made during a landlord-tenant dispute hearing when Justice Srishanand commented on traffic congestion near the Mysore Road flyover, saying it's like being in Pakistan where no rules apply. Chief Justice D.Y. Chandrachoor, heading a five-judge bench, emphasized the need for judicial propriety and stated that they would issue guidelines on the matter. Supreme Court has asked Justice Srishanand to submit a report after consulting the Chief Justice of Karnataka High Court. The next hearing on this matter is scheduled for September 25. Stay updated with our daily coverage of court proceedings. Don't forget to watch and share the video.